Every once in a while, when I'm fortunate, I'll read a book that will stand out, something that I'll remember for years to come. And I'm recommending 10 such books today in mixed fictional genres, starting with recommendation number one. Killing Floor by Lee Child. This is the first installment in the Jack Reacher series. Reacher is basically a vagabond. He doesn't have a car, doesn't have a home. He just wanders around and he gets into predicaments. He's also a badass, an ex-army major. And in this one, he finds himself falsely accused of murder and he goes to prison. This is a really fun mystery. All of them are. I've read four or five of these things now, and Reacher is a really, really interesting personality. I love the guy, and if my recommendation isn't enough, this series is regularly read and recommended by Stephen King. Number two, This Tender Land by William Kent Krueger. This one is a heartfelt drama. It's about a group of kids who escape from a horrible training school, a group of Native American kids, and they go on an adventure. William Kent Krueger talks about this being his version of the Huck Finn story, and I don't know that I've ever read a book that had me so emotionally wrapped up. There are many great themes in this one: love and friendship and hardship. This book gave me a really powerful emotional response, and it was probably the best book that I've read so far this year. Number three, changing it up with a science fiction recommendation, Revelation Space by Alastair Reynolds. This book is the first piece in what was originally a trilogy, and it's a hard science fiction novel that addresses many complex physical and neurological ideas. It asks the question, why don't we see evidence of spacefaring civilizations when we look out into the cosmos? It's a lot of fun concerning escapism to put your mind out among the stars. I like this book a lot, and I think that even if you don't like science fiction, generally speaking, that this one is well worth the read. Number four, a time travel novel by Stephen King, 112263. The title of this book, 112263, is the date that John F. Kennedy was assassinated. A man named Jake Epping goes back in time in an attempt to prevent the Kennedy assassination, but there's a catch. You see, the time warp takes him to October 21st, 1960. He has to live in the past for 3 years to get his chance to change history. This one shows the deep imagination of Stephen King. It's one of his best novels and one of my absolute favorites. Number five, coming at you with a classic, A Study in Scarlet by Arthur Conan Doyle. This one is a murder mystery and the first Sherlock Holmes novel. Dr. Watson meets Sherlock Holmes for the first time, and they are propelled into a murder mystery investigation. I was really surprised at how much I enjoyed this. Sometimes classics can be hard to read. The language can be dated, but this reads totally like a modern mystery novel. This book was really funny and a lot of fun. I laughed aloud as I read it. Sherlock Holmes is truly one of the greatest literary achievements. Number six, Stormfront by Jim Butcher. This is the first installment in the Dresden Files series, and it's one of the most unique things that I have ever read. Jim Butcher manages to merge high-end epic fantasy with detective fiction. Harry Dresden is a wizard, Chicago's only professional wizard, and he gets involved with the Chicago police when there are cases where magic is involved. This book is a lot of fun, seeing the two fictional genres of fantasy and criminal fiction intertwined, Dresden does a great job for a debut novel. I highly recommend this one, and this series has become my new favorite. Number 7, the funniest book that I have ever read. Welcome to Gonzo Fiction, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. This one revolves around a man named Raoul Duke. He's a journalist and he travels out to Las Vegas with his attorney to do some journalism work covering a motorcycle race. Politics is a major theme in this one. Raoul and his attorney do a ton of drugs in this one, and it's absolutely hilarious. I laughed the whole time I read this thing. It's a short read. It's a funny read. Hunter S. Thompson was a literary genius. I've even read some of his short stories, and they are extraordinary. If you are in need of a laugh, I couldn't possibly recommend a better book for you than Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Number 8, The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. I was really surprised that I loved a YA romance novel. I was totally agape when I finished this thing. It revolves around a teenaged girl named Hazel Grace. She has cancer, she's dying, and at a cancer therapy group session, she meets a young man named Gus, who has his own battle with cancer, and it's a love story. It's the perfect setup for a tearjerker. In it, they both love to read. They pursue Hazel's favorite author to ask him some questions about her favorite book. There are very deep philosophical themes in this book. We have teenagers trying to make sense of dying as young people. It's an absolutely epic read is this one, and a quick read. It's one of the most touching books that I have ever read. Number 9, a horror novel by Joe Hill, Nosferatu. This one is about a vampire named Charles Manx, who has the ability to go in between dimensions of reality. In one dimension, he's created this place called Christmas Land, where, similar to Peter Pan's Never Never Land, children don't grow older. It's Christmas every day of the year, and Charles Manx likes to kidnap children and take them there to live with him forever. It's up to Vic McQueen to try to stop Charles Manx, and Joe Hill shows his imagination in this one. Deeply inventive book, very scary as well. Tons of literary references in this one, and many literary references to Stephen King. Joe Hill is Stephen King's son, if you didn't already know, best-selling author. This is a great book. They made a mini-series out of it as well. It's one of the best horror novels that I've ever read. If you're still with me, friends, I have a real treat for you. I found a novel that's not a bestseller, but it is a great book nonetheless. Number 10, The Search for Heinrich Schlögel by Martha Bally. This one's about a German man who loves to go out and experience nature. So he takes a flight to Canada to go out and experience the deep wilderness. He's there for a few weeks or so, not a long trip. And when he comes out of the woods, 30 years have passed by. He has to try to make sense of the world when he comes out of the Canadian woods, and time, history, memory are big themes in this one. This was a very, very touching book. I remember that I read the entirety of it in one day. I was so caught up in it. And it's a book that very few people have heard of, but it's as good as a bestseller, no doubt. If you're looking for a feel-good book with a character that you can empathize with, I give this one a maximum recommendation. Well, there you go. 10 fiction books in various genres, all of which I greatly enjoyed. Let me know what you think, friends, in the comments. Thanks for dropping by. I'll see you next time.